Good morning, Polly's Island peeps. Today is November 15th, 2020. And it is such an amazing Sunday to recycle, to find needs in the community and give towards them. And then one other thing, there was one other national day today. Let's see. Well, it's such a beautiful sunrise morning. The tide is high. At 7:30 this morning will be the peak high tide. I know what it was. It was clean out your refrigerator. It's such a great Sunday to clean out your refrigerator. So those are the three national days today. Good morning, Janice, all the way from Pittsburgh. Yes, thank you, Lee. You have to make room for eggnog. And the only way to do that is to clean out your refrigerator. So if you look at the weather here in Polly's Island, it's supposed to be sunny every day for the next 7 days. I don't remember the last time that I saw the sun, when you look down at each day, that many days in a row. It's pretty cool. So it's about 70 degrees out here. It's nice and warm. Water temperature is 72, and the wind is out of the south today. So let's talk about Andrew Carnegie for a second, since it is National Philanthropy Day. We're going to talk about three different national days today. So the Recycle Day is today. It's actually Raisin Bran Day too, but I didn't want to talk about Raisin Bran. Although some of you might really like Raisin Bran, and it's okay. But then we're going to talk about cleaning our refrigerators because it's National Clean Your Refrigerator Day. But first, let's talk about Andrew Carnegie. So he's a Scottish American, right? Back in the late 1800s. And he came to this country, I don't want to say with nothing, but I'll say with almost nothing. And he worked in a factory initially, but then he grew his wealth, which would be equivalent to $350 billion today. That's what his equivalent wealth was in the early 1900s. So, Andrew Carnegie, later in life, decided that he really wanted to make a difference in the education of people. And he felt like reading was a huge, huge part of that. So Andrew Carnegie gave enough money for the United States of America to build 1,500 libraries, public libraries, 1,500 of them. And he also gave a lot of money towards colleges. So just to give you an idea, the amount of money Andrew Carnegie gave would be equivalent to $35 billion, that's with a B, dollars today. So that's just pretty amazing. So in the philanthropy world, I think of him. And he felt like education had really helped him in his life. So that's what he gave towards. So pretty neat. So what does your refrigerator look like today? So that's the next national day to talk about. Do you have lots of leftovers that probably aren't clean to eat and safe to eat? I think I might. So I'm gonna look in the fridge and try to clean it out a little bit. And then the last thing I want to talk about is recycling. This is really important to my wife. And it's to me too, because it's important to her and it's grown on me. She used to tell us whenever we throw water bottles in the trash can and not recycle them, she would say, she'd get really mad at us. And then she'd say, I'm not gonna allow you to kill my polar bears. And I just love that. So we recycle and we love it. We love to do it. It's fun. It's part of my Sunday routine to go to the dump and to put the plastics with the plastics and the glass with the glass, the right colors. And then also to look for things that might be cool to recycle. So sometimes people put things on the side there and sometimes I'll just bring it back. Because I think a big part of recycling is reusing things that maybe someone just didn't have room for and so they chose to throw it away. So if you can reuse that, that's great. So we love doing that. And it's essential for us. Because we can't afford to buy something every day. So there's the three national days today. I kind of like that day. I like it today. Still, we have not heard whether we have a Pawleys Island Shell Day yet. Good morning, Lisa Arnold. It is beautiful. I agree. So I just got to show you all this real quick. Look at all the sunny days ahead of us. Isn't that incredible? So this morning we might have a little sprinkle or two, but look at all those sunny days. Boom. The future looks bright. Sunrise is 6:48, so we have 7 minutes. Me too, William. Me too. So y'all ready for some good news? I know I am. Good morning, Holly Cervini. Thank you so much for being a part of this show, being a part of our mornings. Yesterday was awesome. So today's great news comes from Psalm 9:1, and that is, I will give thanks to you, Lord, with all my heart. I will tell of all of your wonderful deeds. And then another version, which I really loved, and I put in the very top there. I'm going to try to find it. Says, I will give thanks to you, Lord, with all of my heart. I will tell the world of all you have done for me. What do you think of that? So what part of your day, what part of my day do I spend telling others my story about what God is doing in my life and around with my family and with my friends? What part of my day do I spend telling others about that? I could just picture David being a shepherd, being out there and facing all kinds of danger, and then coming, bringing the sheep into safety, and then maybe another shepherd like wanders over a couple hours later, and David looks at this other shepherd and he says, "You will not believe what God did for me just about an hour ago. I was surrounded by all of these crazy animals, and I was sure I was a goner. And then guess what God did for me? He brought this torrential downpour, and it rained so hard that all of these predators that were going to kill my sheep and probably kill me, he allowed that downpour to save my life, and we were able to escape." Can't you just hear David telling his story? What What is your story? The blessings or the unanswered prayers that God is doing in your life? Answered prayers or unanswered prayers? Good morning to you, sir.
Look, we're gonna get a sunrise and a shower at the same time.
There you go. Or maybe your story is like David's with Goliath. What a story he has there. Where he was the sure goner, right? Everyone said there's no way that he's going to be able to defeat Goliath. There's no way. But that's not David's story. David's story was that he killed Goliath and he gave all the credit to God. His confidence to defeat Goliath. I gotta think that there's people that I know or that I don't know that might need that encouraging story, that you know, that encouragement. Maybe when they're talking about something that relates, maybe that moment is the opportunity to share your story and encourage them. So that's what I think the scripture's about in my life. It's prodding me. It's not only to come live here and just say, wow, this is awesome. And it is. This is tremendous. But also to be intentional during the day. Maybe it's someone struggling in a marriage. And I can share how God has restored my marriage. Maybe it's someone struggling with defeatist attitude or victim attitude. And then I can share how we are more than victors through Christ. And I can share how in my life, God is working on that in my life, that I'm no longer shameful. I'm not ashamed. So I'm going to be quiet. And let y'all enjoy this time together here. I sure will, Victor. And that is what we're talking about. That is our challenge for the day, is to share our story with others so that we might be a blessing to them. Share the story, share what God has done in your life. So that's our challenge for the day and for every day. May God bless you. May God keep you. And may God help you make His choices this day and every day. And share them with others. Love you guys. What a morning. Just gorgeous. Love you guys.